Hey David, this is you. Almost 10 years from now. I'm 26, you're 16. So, yeah, smoking. Honestly, quitting wasn't too terribly hard, but I don't think it was. I think that's because I wasn't like it. I mean, cigarettes are addictive. I definitely was addicted to it, but I don't think I was addicted to it the level that is normally expected of an addiction. If I was, you know, actually addicted to the normal level, I guess it would have been much harder. But the fact of the matter is, you didn't smoke. You don't smoke that much. When you smoke, you chain smoke. You smoke like, I don't know, when you smoke at a time, you smoke like 2 packs or 3 packs even. You do chain smoke, but you don't do it frequently. It's not like you smoke every day. So I think that's a reason why quitting smoking for me, for you, is not that hard. I mean, it is tough. It's something that comes up again and again and again in time. But initially, you go cold turkey, and you're able to kind of succeed from your first try in quitting. Also, I think the reason you picked up quitting is probably an important factor. I think at the time, what you are going through right now is the beginning process of your deconversion from Christianity. You're starting to question things. You're starting to have, I think at this point, I don't know if you've done or not, but I think at this point you read Lies My Teacher Told Me, Everything Your American History Textbook Got Wrong. That's really the catalyst there. That book is the catalyst for you. And then you read the Bible in a whole different light after that book. And I don't know if you started that, but if you started reading that, then the deconversion process has already begun. If you started reading that, then you are starting to become an atheist. I think I, you know, after you read like 5 chapters, you watch this movie called The Moscow on the Hudson. I don't know why this movie has this effect on me, on you, because it shouldn't have. It's not a movie about atheism or religion at all. But it strikes you in such an emotional way that you start questioning everything that you hold dear in your belief. So you're going to start watching that. You're going to read the Bible again. This is your third time reading the Bible. This will be your third time reading the Bible from beginning to end. And during that read-through is when you start questioning your own faith. But yeah, you're starting this deconversion phase, which is a stressful thing. Starting this deconversion process is a stressful thing. So you do kind of pick up cigarette smoking. You do go out with your buddies and you smoke joints and you do marijuana and you do bongs and stuff. This is your beginning of kind of trying it out kind of thing. You feel like a rebel now in some ways. Also, a big, big stress factor is, by this point, I believe you, because you're, this is, I think, late 16 you are, you know, you're about, what, like 16 and 9 months, I think, years old. But, yeah, there's this, you know, someone you consider as a really close friend, and you liked her, as liking her. Looking back, it almost feels... It's inaccurate to say this, but almost feels like you do fall in love with her. But that doesn't work out. So obviously, you just come from that not working out, and you know, you're going through that stress again. So this is all kinds of mixed up stress thing that you're going through, so you pick up smoking to kind of help with that. It's none of those things are easy to overcome, but you do overcome it. And I think because you overcome it is why you're able to quit smoking, because that's kind of the reason you did it anyway. Also, another side factor was you picked it up kind of as a rebel to your dad. I think at some points you wanted to just be found by your dad caught smoking red-handed. And you do get caught one time, and your dad gets really mad at you. My dad gets really mad at me. Sorry, this is really weird talking to me. But, you know, that's one of those things. You know, you had your reasons for, I guess, factors into why you picked it up. You don't do it every day. You don't really do it frequently. It's just that when you do, you just smoke like crazy. That I think that's been kind of my personality is I wouldn't, you know, I smoke like 3 packs one day. California cigarette prices are really cheap. I smoke like 3 packs one day, and then I don't know, I don't smoke for like after that, like for 3 weeks straight, and then I pick it up again smoking like 2 packs or 3 packs. So when I smoke, I chain smoked, but I don't smoke frequently. So I think that was one of the reasons why it was easy to quit. Here's the thing though. Smoking is addictive. The nicotine in there is really, really addictive. So this is an interesting story. 5 months after I quit, you know, I still used to write a lot, like with pen and paper, which I rarely do nowadays. But 5 months after I quit, I still used to write a lot. And there is a lot of time when I, you know, write something and I would be thinking, and with my pen, I would be doing this without realizing that I'm doing that. And then I would smell my fingers and be like, that's the smell of cigarettes. Like, whoa, I'm subconsciously doing this and wanting, you know, to have that nicotine kick. So subconsciously, it's still there. The addiction to cigarettes are powerful, powerful thing. Nicotine is really that powerful. So there is no question that cigarettes are addictive. But I think there's a lot of ways in which I can explain why quitting for me was easier than it should have been. It was not super hard. It was challenging in ways because of the subconscious ways in which I, you know, was telling myself that without even realizing that I wanted to smoke. So in some ways, it's challenging, but it wasn't super hard. I was able to go cold turkey and then succeeded. And I haven't really smoked since. I did smoke like 5 months ago. I smoked like, you know, three sticks, I think. And that was because we went to this Colorado for this this event thingy, and it was a very stressful thing. And then we had a total mental breakdown at one point, our group, and I ended up smoking like 3 sticks. But yeah, I'm not addicted anymore. I quit. I succeeded in quitting simply because really the biggest motivator for me in quitting was the price of cigarettes in New York City, which is ridiculous. A regular pack would cost about $13 a pack. And a discount price, and this is considered discount price, is like $11 or $9 a pack, which is ridiculous because you remember in California, you were able to get a pack, you know, for $3.50, for $4. Sometimes you can get those deals where it's buy one, get one free. So you can get 2 packs for $4. New York City, 1 pack at a discount price cost $9. So yeah, obviously, just looking at that price, I had to quit, and I did. It wasn't super challenging. There was a lot of subconscious things to deal with, but I think there's plenty of reasons why it was not as hard for me as it should have been. All right, cheers.